Und damit kann es weitergehen mit Let's Play Fake Grand Order. Ich bin es, Adam Simafix. Beim letzten Mal haben wir hier ein seltsames Bündnis geschlossen mit Squishingua. Ich werde mir seinen Namen nie merken können. So wie er sich nicht Körnaskas Namen nicht merken kann, den ich mir auch nicht merken kann. Egal. Zumindest, ja, wir haben aktuell ein Bündnis mit ihnen und erleben hier in Frieden. Die werte Kryptorin soll uns hier nicht angreifen, doch die Frage ist, hält sie sich hier daran? Ja, denn beim letzten Mal sah es eher nicht danach aus. Nun gut, Leute, ich würde mal sagen, wir starten hier einfach mal weiter mit der nächsten Sektion, die inzwischen so in Sektion 8 heißt, Land of Peace. Ja, so mache ich meine Kapitel am liebsten. Ein Kapitel, kein Kampf und ein gratis Quartz. Wieso kann das Spiel, ganze Spiel nicht so sein? Einfach kein Kämpfen und nur Quartz. So sollte es sein, das wäre richtiger Frieden. Gebt mir das Land voller Quartz. Sounds like you had quite the evening. Peculiar tough, this may be it. It does present another piece of the puzzle. Unfortunately, it does nothing to make the larger picture any easier to see. We know that the Crypta's first priority is defending the Tree of Emptiness. And yet, Akuta has not told this lost belt king of the tree's importance. Furthermore, she moved to eliminate us entirely on her own discretion, only to end up swearing allegiance to Quishing Huang the instant Zhang Yu's life was threatened. Ja genau, das haben wir nämlich, das war ja das Ende, das habe ich ganz vergessen zu erwähnen. Zhang Yu wurde ja hier von Quishonghua, hoffentlich killt ihn, Mann. Also, ihr besser euch beide gegenseitig killen, wurde hier bedroht. Und dann hat sie ja auf einmal gesagt, hey, mein geliebter Ehemann. Hä? Habe ich jetzt nicht verstanden. Aber okay, liebe Leute, vielleicht ist sie irgendeine Reinkarnation, ja, vielleicht ist sie ein Wahrheit-Servant, vielleicht sind wir alle ein Wahrheit-Servant. Übrigens, unser Hauptcharakter ist, habe ich gehört, ist ein legendärer YouTuber. Der die Welt damals gerettet, in der Zukunft die Welt rettet, ihr wisst ja so, bis er ihm ja mäßig.
I was taken aback to see Akuta acting so aggressively when we first came to this lost belt. But seeing her so scared and flustered was just painful, more than it was surprising.
Ach, die soll gefängst weinen und sterben, Mann.
I guess I really didn't know anything about her back when we were both at Chaldea.
Ah yes, about who she was at Chaldea.
Holmes and I did a little poking around in the data we managed to get back from the server.
Hallo.
And her entire background reeks of false-filled records.
Indeed, I had not particularly hauled my nose as we picked apart her disguise.
Disguise? Even though she was a member of Cartier staff?
Let's see, imagine a profile is like a painting that's been thoroughly metaphorically airbrushed to erase any trace of her original painter.
Correct. There was not a single errant brushstroke, so to speak, to be found anywhere. Anyone who has lived an ordinary life will inevitably leave behind a bit of useless information about him or herself along the way. And yet, there was nothing to the sort to be found in Akute Inokustada. It was as though her entire life was designed to pull the wool over someone's eyes.
You mean like an intricate piece of fiction?
Precisely. You're as quick to catch on as ever, Maxi.
So the fact that nothing is personal information is strange also means nothing in it is real.
Yep, yep, yep. There's basically nothing even remotely human about her entirely background. And even that's not the only obviously suspicious thing we ran across.
According to her profile, Marisbury Amnosphere brought her to Chaldea, supervised her aptitude test, and oversaw her periodic health exams and interviews personally. It seems every bit of data about her was submitted with his aforesaid code, no one else.
Das heißt, er wusste, dass mit ihr etwas nicht stimmt.
The first director.
Just the fact that he handled it all alone is a one hell of a red flag for security. It'd be easy for him to falsify any data he wanted, considering his position.
Be that as it may, if Cardia's original rector was the one who manipulated the profile...
Yeah, if a guy that high up the food chain had something he wanted to keep secret about her, we're pretty much so. How did Akuta end up at Chaldea in the first place?
Did she actually have enough race shift aptitude to be chosen for Team A? For that matter, who the hell is she really? At this point, I don't know what to believe.
Indeed, everything we thought we knew about Akuta Sinoku's personal information is suspect at best.
So, it wouldn't really be a stretch to imagine she might have a different goal from the other cryptos.
Obviously not. What's more, this goal is evidently more important to her than protecting her lost belt or preserving her relationship with Fritz King. One might think eliminating us would be the first priority, but as we've seen, even that is secondary compared to her concern for Zhang Yu, another figure about whom we know next to nothing.
It looks like that name only means anything to this...
Es geht nicht so.
Off to those of us from proper human history. In this lost belt he appears to go by something else.
I think he was called Kaiju Zero. Innocent Kaiju. So wie meine gute Mikaeli. Kaiju.
Well, a quick database search suggests that area has some significance for Zhang Yu. It's where his uncle Zhang Liang started his revolt against the Qin Empire after the emperor died. You could say it's where Zhang Yu began his career as a warrior.
Regardless of who Zhang Yu may be in this world, the fact remains that he belongs to this lost belt. So I cannot faith in Wayakute Hinoku who... Though nothing else we know about her is certain, come from proper human history, will care so deeply about him as to abandon her other goals.
That's one pretty straightforward. She must have fallen in love with him at first sight. The more foolish the woman, the more likely she is to chuck everything away for such silly notions.
Careful, Gordy. You're gonna lose any goodwill you may have built up with your female stuff.
Bah! The only woman here's Mesh, your born-line Lolita. Oh!
Well, I was certainly disappointed by what you said.
Right? Really?
Now, to try to stay on topic, we still have a mountain of problems that need solving.
Sehr gut, Mann. Immer schafft das immer ein bisschen die Stimmung immer zu aufzulockern.
Alright, we still need to talk to the people who's gonna be less than pleased about this.
Ja, ah, Jinke. Achso, ich dachte, wir sagen jetzt Quishun Wang, sagen wir gleich, dass das in Wahrheit Akuta eine Böse ist und der tötet sie einfach so. Das wäre super.
Even if it is only temporary, I can't believe I have to pretend to make nice with that emperor. Just the thought makes me sick.
Yeah, that sounds about right.
Negotiate out of the question. The tactic plays right into the oppressor's hands. Do not be fooled, detective. They will tell you whatever they request to hear and pressure you into swearing a lie with only the pretense of your consent at best.
Given the urgency of Mr. Maxi and Gorlov's condition, I'm afraid we have no alternative. At a minimum, I would like to maintain our truce with Quishing Wang until Kionosuke is securely in our custody. If you could prolong it until Akute Hinako is out of the picture, so much the better. Whatever the reason for doing so may be, Akute Hinako remained fiercely determined to eradicate us. So much so that she tried to assassinate Mr. Maxi in the deed of night against Quishing Huang's wishes.
Obviously, Akuta and Quishing Huang aren't exactly BFFs at the moment. But we can't be sure that they will last since there's still a lot we don't know about their relationship. There's every possibility that she may yet convince Quishing Huang to take her side in all of this.
What about defeating Quishing Huang and cutting down the tree of emptiness before Music and Master can fail victim to this accursed poison? Should the nappy have first priority?
Das blinkt aber leider Goldorf nicht weiter.
Listen closely, Spartacus. At the moment, making an enemy out of all of the Empire will lead only to disaster. Right now, Kionosuke is a wild card who could wreak havoc no matter where she is or whose side she is on. If we don't have an antidote ready to go by the time we face off with Quishing Huang, it will be over before it begins. All the Emperor would have to do is kill Kionosuke, and Mr. Maxi would be saddled with the poison's deleterious effect for the rest of his life.
Let's not forget that my own life would be tragically shortened.
Yes, ultimately we'd need to destroy the Tree of Emptiness and erase this lost belt, and to do so, we will inevitably need to face and defeat Quishing Huang.
Ach, chinesisch, ja, der Partner.
So bear in mind that any ambivalence relationships we appear have now are strictly temporary state of affairs.
They want us to pretend to be friends until we can attack when the Emperor least expect it, right? Yeah, that's fine. Hell, I used to ask Agarain for advice with sort of sneaky shit all the time.
I refuse. Acquiescence is the first step of to alliance, and alliance inevitably leads to subservience. My master must never side with oppression, but always rebel against it. He should rebel against pain, rebel against suffering, and ultimately triumph by rebelling against destiny.
Der ist so krass, Mann, der Typ, Mann. Ich war Spartacus, wenn ich mir überlegt, dass er in September einfach nur mal war, oh, du tötet die Unterdrücker. Und hier ist er wirklich eigentlich im Endeffekt recht irgendwie hat.
Get the goddamn stick out of your ass, would you? We're playing the long game here, lunkhead. The important part is that we get to destroy the Empire in the end. So, why don't you just think of all the rebelling you're gonna get to do later as a prize for all the restraint you gotta show now? I mean, you love repressing your own shit, right?
Oh, you are truly willing to go along with this?
Jetzt tut er sich gegen uns setzen. When I tried to initiate the Emperor before, I lost the moment I focused on something other than killing itself. But I'm not the one leading the attack this time. I get that Maxi has his own way of fighting. I'm sorry, I know it's a lot to ask. Well, there's nothing I can do if you're going to plead at me with that helpless look on your face. I mean, you're just now realizing how hopeless your chances are against Zhang Yu, right?
Er wendet sich gegen uns. It's getting stuffy in here with so many of us present. I think I step out for a bit of fresh air.
Huh? Homs just winked at me, Senpai. And Jinky, what's going on?
Ja, aber Spartacus uns angreifen wird.
What is it, Holmes?
Is there something else you wanted to talk to us about?
I thought it would be the best if Spartacus were absent for this next part. I trust you to retain your cool, Miss Jinky. But let me remind you to refrain from raising your voice as long as we whisper. Queen Shi Huang should be unable to hear us. I've mostly finished my analysis of the benefaction drug, and it's beyond anything I could have imagined. Its psychotropic effects are secondary at most. Its true purpose lies in boosting the immune system, or perhaps I should say, enhancing it to an unfathomable degree. And despite its potency, there are almost no negative side effects as long as one condition remains unmet. It is well beyond what modern medical science could achieve. In fact, I doubt even magecraft from proper human history could create a drug so effective. It is something that could only be made here, in a lost belt where pharmaceutical and biochemistry are entirely based on sage arts.
Now I see, so it's mass produced elixir.
And they just sent out something that amazing to every citizen during every major celebration.
Indeed, and as a result, illness and disease have been completely eradicated. I doubt any of these people have had so much as a cold since they were born.
Then it's a real, actual panicker.
Hold on! What's the condition that needs to go amend for this to work?
Ah yes, that would be old age. Once a person's hormone secretion has reached a certain level, this drug functions as a lethal antiseptic. I estimate it to be at least several thousand times more potent than pinotrudial. Hang on, wouldn't it mean?
Now I see. I thought it was strange that we hadn't seen a single elderly person here.
This is no unintended side effect. It's quite clear that the medicine was designed to work this way.
Designed? Then it really is poisoning everyone who takes it. So, when someone's body secretes a certain amount of hormones, in other words, once the body has aged to a certain point, they just die?
Correct. From our perspective, distributing a drug like this is no better than a mass murder. Still, a case can be made from a Buddhist perspective on how to use the four inevitables of human life, namely birth, aging, disease, and death. If one considers both old age and illness equally undesirable, one could say this medicine protects you from the pain to the former and the latter at once. I cannot say if every world, under all possible conditions, would eventually arrive at this ethics of pharmaceutical science. But the wheat grown here has been extensively genetically modified into something extraordinary. Its resistance to disease, its yield, everything about it stands leagues above its natural counterpart in proper human history. With a crop like this, one could live their entire life without ever knowing hunger. And if you never had to worry about food, you probably never think to take it from someone else. There's no economy here, no division between rich and poor exists, and we have all seen for ourselves how ignorant they are of war and violence. It seems that life here is far removed from the suffering that one might expect in our world as it is possible to imagine. And when their lives has run its course, this drug puts them to sleep permanently, well before they can begin to feel the pain of old age. I dare see that, if nothing else. This world has done a frighteningly effective job at removing pain and suffering from people's lives.
But it's still...
That's no way for people to live. They are practically being kept as livestock. So this is how Kui Shun Huang, how the dictator decided to solve humanity's suffering? Makes sense. No way a leader who abandoned their own humanity would in turn treat their subject like people. As far as making a decision between this lost belt and proper human history. Spartacus claimed that we should fight to determine which should be allowed to survive. If hearing that gave us pure pause, I would urge you to give the matter more thought, keeping that you know now about the benefaction of mind. In this world, the definition of a happy human life is exceedingly simple. Kurz leben, glücklich leben. Seeing as you will need to make this choice sooner or later, I think I'd best suspend my usual behavior in favor of a full disclosure. Allow me to share with you some speculation. Do keep in mind that this is not a deduction, but rather a bit of conjecture on my own part.
Holmes!
This relates solely on one question, namely, why did the Spirit Ocean Graph fail to work with this Lost Belt's ley line?
You think it has something to do with this medicine?
That may be not be directly related, but it does support my current hypothesis. Heroic spirits have always been one side of a liar. Mankind's collective unconsciousness. They are defined foremost by their purpose, protecting humanity. While there may be many different methods and conditions involved in summoning servants, the one they all have in common, without exception, is responding to the summoner's prayer. However, if there was not a single person in the world who had the empathic need to pray for something, and if such a world had flourished unabated for hundreds of years,
right, then wouldn't be it surprising if that world lost its connection to the throne of heroes entirely.
For that matter, there wouldn't even be any heroic spirits in that world, just like there aren't here. After all, a hero might be needed to fight someday, like Queen Liang is still alive.
So, this lost belt is a world that has no need for a rock spirit at all.
Can you imagine a person wishing fervently for anything in a world free from hunger, pain and suffering, Miss Kirolite? I certainly cannot. Indeed, it only makes sense that servants would never appear in a world where no one wishes for anything.
Thanks for telling us this, Holmes. Whatever doubts I might have had are gone now.
I will do everything in my power to take Kui Shun Huang down and put an end to this disgusting regime. As long as I get there in the end, I don't care how far out of our way we have to go. So right now, let's focus on curing Maxi. Now that I know where I'm going, I can wait as long as it takes.
Thank you, Chinky.
Eine Welt ohne Schmerz. Aber trotzdem keine Welt, in der man leben kann.
Progress report!
We should finish our complete scan of the vehicle interior by morning.
Good. Be careful not to overlook anything.
Remember, the future of the Empire rests on your shoulders.
Yes, ma'am.
I go see how things are outside.
Wo ist dieser verdammte Landling? Tötet ihn!
The Shadow Border. The product of a world entirely different from ours. Because the moon does not know how to drink, my shadows merely follows the movement of my body. The moon has brought the shadow to keep me company a while. The practice of mirth should keep pace with spring.
What was it, young man?
Oh, that was called a poem. A guy named Leah Bai wrote it a long time ago.
Who taught you that?
Well...
Okay. Scheinbar mag sie keine Gerichte.
We see Queen Liao's investigation is proceeding smoothly. It feels good to have so much data moving among our circuits.
Do you think you will be able to analyze that over worldly device, Your Imperial Majesty?
Who do you think we are? This holy vessel's full calculation capabilities can easily handle a single vehicle. Oh, so we thought. This is amazing. How could they fit so much functionality into those dimensions? It's hard to believe what we are seeing.
Forgive the intrusion, Your Imperial Majesty, but there's something you should know.
Hmm? What is this about?
The children in this village are reciting poems.
You're kidding!
When I asked them about it, they said they learned from Chaldea.
We see. Then Chaldea are Confucians.
Was? Wir sagen nichts zu Konfuzius. Ich glaube an gar nichts!
Yes, Your Imperial Majesty. This is undoubtedly the work of Confucianism.
Okay, wie gesagt, mit diesen ganzen chinesischen Geschichten kenne ich mich jetzt leider sehr wenig aus. Aber Konfuzius war natürlich ein großer Denker in dieser schönen Welt. Und ich habe so das ungute Gefühl, dass der werte Herr das nicht mag. Ich habe so das ganz ungute Gefühl, Mann. Wenn immer denn irgendwas Cooles, ich weiß nicht, ich werde das eben mit meiner Sansan-Kombi machen, dann... Da! Ich könnte eigentlich sogar Mordry nehmen, einfach mal so, damit die Olle mal wieder hier reinkommt. Warte mal, nehme ich nicht meine Quid-Monster-Party, meine It's Magic-Party nehme ich, packe ihn noch Shakespeare ein. Und dann vernichten wir dieses Viechmann. Also, erste Runde mit ihrem MP, zweite Runde mit Sansangs MP und dritte Runde, keine Ahnung mit wem. Also, Section 9. Morningstar Rebellion. Komm, Jean-Yu, ich bin bereit, Mann. Ich hau dich so weg, Mann. Egal, wie viel Breakboss du hast, Mann. Ich hau's zumindest. So.
Imagine, Spartacus is no longer with us.
Okay, ich nehme alles zurück, wir müssen gegen Spartacus kämpfen.
What?
Who?
That's not all. A member of villagers have gone missing as well. The ones who remain said, as they saw Spartacus leading villagers to a decap.
Das ist deine Schuld, Stinke, nur weil du das Dichten auf einmal anfängst.
Bruh. If the Emperor sees that, he think we are leading a rebellion. What is wrong with that muscle-bound moron? How could he do this?
Hey, Berserker ain't exactly much for thinking or planning, but he's just being true to himself. Hell, he couldn't change who he is even if he wanted to.
Do something, Maxi. Can your records mention him obeying to Roman? If he can listen to her...
He can listen to... Achso, to that Roman. Achso, mein Nero. Soll ich meine Nero auspacken? Ich habe hier meine gegradete Level 100 Nero. That was between Nero and Spartacus, not me. Und jeder gehorcht meiner Nero. Auch du, Goldorf.
What's with that knowing look? All those common spells of your just fancy tattoos? Go on, you say I want over you, fool.
Nein, die brauche noch gegen Zhang Yu. This may be the moment of truth, Mr. Maxi. Forming a contract with an unruly berserker inevitably mean using command spells to keep them in check. You may not care for that idea, but it is something you will need to come to terms with sooner or later.
It is frankly miraculous that you've come so far without ever having to force your servants to obey. I would likely nothing more than to respect your wishes, but I'm afraid that...
Hold up!
Moderate?
You're not gonna make Spotty Toad to a line just by forcing him to stop with a command spell. All they'll do is just root him in place. So please, Master, whatever you do, don't use a command spell on him. If you do, he might end up forgetting his whole reason for leaving the Frono to come here and help.
Foo-foo.
Can you let me handle him, Master? I'm sure I can convince him to stop.
How might that be?
How do you think? By beating the ever-living shit out of him.
Das ist meine Mordet.
You see, it's his legs and stuff just keeping him going. Long as those are running him to fight, he's not gonna stop for anything. So, if you just hit him so hard that his knees give out,
then he'll get through this thick skull underneath the bell silver.
Are you quite certain that would be better than a command spell?
Positive. I give you the moral guarantee.
Is the wirklich viel wert? I confess that even I cannot see the logic here.
What do you think, Mr. Maxi? This is ultimately your decision to make. I'm counting on you, Mordred.
Ist ja nicht so, als würde Mordred immer jemanden verraten haben. Ihr kann man vertrauen.
Hell yeah, don't worry. I've got this. Phew, phew. I go with you. I think I may be partly to blame for the villagers' decision to join him.
I assume, Miss Tinke, wouldn't you rather be there leading the way with him?
Truthfully, yes. Honestly, kind of envy him getting to Matilda as a berserker.
Because he can throw caution to the wind and do whatever he feels like in a given moment?
Nope. Because he, even though he's a berserker, he's got such a good master. As a rogue spirit myself, I can't help but feel a little jealous of that. Nata, hold down the fort. The borders are our lifeline here, so make sure you don't let anything happen to it.
Leave it to me. I await your turn.
Okay, everyone, let's go bring Spartacus and the villagers back.
Übrigens, ich bin mir ganz sicher, wie es laufen wird. Guizhong Huang will hier in Wahrheit hier die Leute, also, weiß ich nicht, entführen, will sie wegbringen, nur um sie zu schützen, weil ich irgendwas hatte scheinbar hier an diesem Konfuzius-Zeugel hier, dem werten Emperor, nicht so getaugt.
Hey Spartacus, are you sure about this? I thought we weren't supposed to leave our village fields.
Yes, I'm sure. No system, no ethics, no law can never stop one from working about freely. One's path always lies ahead of wherever your own two feet take you.
Übrigens, diese Stimme ist immer voll anstrengend, aber irgendwie finde ich die passt der Spartacus.
I don't know. We thought that Heavenly Emperor gave us those fields as a gift of love.
If the Otters wish to call their oppression love, then it is only right to you to return the love in the form of rebellion.
I don't think I understand. Ich auch nicht.
No matter. You will come to understand as we continue our work. Now the oppressor's capital.
The capital? The Heavenly Emperor lives? Huh? Come to think of it, I heard that's got something called art.
Art? Is that anything like those poems Chinky's been sharing with us?
I wanna hear lots more poems, and I wanna see what the capital looks like too.
Well said. Then let us be on our way, singing songs of liberation all the while.
Hold it, hold it! Do you really think we were gonna let you do this, you freaking dumbass? Don't you think it was a touch rude to just wander off without so much as a goodbye?
If it is the antidote for Maxilic concerns, you rest assured, I will bring it back after seeing those responsible brought to justice. If you doubt it, I am doing the right thing, then merely sit down and wait my return. I must give this Guizhong Huang oppressor the firm embrace he deserves. I already know the Emperor is a Qing Yang, and it remains now to continue onward until I reach this great oppressor.
Please stop the Spartacus.
I can understand why you have doubts, Master Maxi. After all, you have yet to attain real strength for yourself. All the more reason why I must go, to show by example what true justice is. As such, I will not hesitate to crush anything that stands in my way with true rebellious love.
Yep, I knew it. You ain't gotta listen to a word we say. Yep, time for my genius plan. If you won't listen to reason, we'll just have to beat it into him. Come on, Spartacus, let you and me hash things out.